Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, so now we are going to start with a new concept of partial differentiation of second order. So here I am taking the first numerical to explain you the concept of partial differentiation of second order. So here we will learn how to apply that concept on any given function. So here we have u as x to the power y, and we have to show that do del square u, So here u is x to the power y, and we have to show that del cube u upon del square x del y is equal to del cube u by del x del y del x. Now guys, here on both sides we have cube, it means the degree is 3, and therefore it's called as the higher order differential equation. So basically these are the higher order differential terms. I won't say it as an equation because this has come in the show that term. So we have to show these two results, but since this degree is greater than 1, this becomes the higher order terms. So this is the second order and this is the third order term. So guys, let's verify this result. So basically we are gonna verify the result by finding out the values of LHS and RHS. So let's start. So here to get this left hand side, now how to proceed? So we have to differentiate this u 3 times, one with respect to y and twice with respect to x partially. Now guys, we have to follow the given order and we should get the answer whatever is the value, and then we will follow the order which is given on the right hand side and we'll get one value, and we'll prove that these two values are exactly same, because in the first video where I've explained you how to find out the partial differentiation, there I've shown you one property which says that even though we change this order of differentiation, we get the same answer. So now it is the right time to prove that property and to show that we get the same answer even though we change the order of differentiation. So let's start. So here value of u is given. So here what I'll do is I'll first find out del u by del y. So we'll start from RHS and then we'll move to the LHS. So to find out del u by del y, we have to partially differentiate this u, that is x to the power y, with respect to y. So here x will be treated as constant, because in partial differentiation we know whatever is the variable of differentiation, apart from that all other variables are treated as constant. So x will be treated as constant. So guys, it will look similar to the format of a to the power x. So whenever we find out the derivative of a to the power x, here this base a is a constant and this x is the variable of differentiation. So now in our case, y is the variable of differentiation and this x is a constant. So by using this result of differentiation, we will get x to the power y into log of x, because here constant is a, so we get log a. Similarly here we will get log x. So we got the first value. Now let's move to the left hand side. So now we'll find out del square u by del x del y. Now guys, for this I have to differentiate this del u by del y with respect to x partially. So the value of del u by del y is this. So I'm gonna differentiate this value with respect to x partially. Now guys, in this value there are two functions, both function have x. So here I'm gonna use the rule of u into v. So by using that rule of differentiation, or I would say the product rule of differentiation, we will get x to the power y as it is, derivative of this term, that is 1 by x, plus log x as it is, and now the derivative of this term is x to the power y minus 1 into y. Now as here how I got this answer. So let me show you that result also. So we have seen a formula, that is derivative of x to the power n is n x raised to n minus 1. So here we have x to the power y, where y is a constant because we are differentiating with respect to x. So that will become y, which is n, so that y, and x to the power y minus 1. Now here, if I take this x in the numerator, that will become x to the power minus 1, and these two terms together will become x to the power y minus 1. Now here also we have a term x to the power y minus 1, so I am taking that term common. So in the bracket, from here we will get only 1, and from here we will get y into log of x. So guys, this is the value of second order. Now let's find out the third order. So for that we have to again differentiate with respect to x. So guys, here I'll say that del cube y upon del square x del y is equal to del by del x of del square u by del x del y. So it means we are gonna differentiate this value or this function with respect to x again. So by differentiating with respect to x, here we'll get del square x del y as it is, and here we will get del cube y. Now guys, value of this function, here we got it as x to the power y minus 1 1 plus y log x. Now here again we have two functions, and in both functions we have x. So again I am going to use the product rule of derivative because I am differentiating with respect to x. So if I am differentiating with respect to x partially, it means guys, we have to treat y as constant. So let's start. So here x to the power y minus 1 will remain as it is, and now I am going to differentiate this term with respect to x. So here we'll get 0, here y is constant, for log x we'll get 1 upon x, so that becomes y by x. So here I'll straightforward write y upon x plus the second function, that is 1 plus y log of x as it is, and now let's differentiate this with respect to x. So y minus 1 is a constant, so we will get derivative as y minus 1 x to the power y minus 2. So guys, this is the answer. Now if I take this x in the numerator, that will become x to the power minus 1, and x to the power minus 1 x to the power y minus 1 will become x to the power y minus 2. So x to the power y minus 2 x to the power y minus 2 is common, I can take it outside, and in the bracket from here we will get y, from here we will get plus y minus 1 into 1 plus y log x. So guys, this is the value of LHS. So here I got the value of LHS. Now let's call it as equation number 1, and let's move to the RHS. So let's find out the value of RHS. Let's call it as equation number 2, and let's observe if both values are same. If it is same, then the result is proved. So let's start. So here again I'll start from the right hand side. So first we'll find out the value of del u by del x. So here del u upon del x equal to, so it means I have to partial differentiate u with respect to x. This is the value of u. So if I differentiate this with respect to x, y will be treated as constant, so the derivative will become y x to the power y minus 1. Now let's find out next value, that is let's differentiate with respect to y. So we will get del square u by del y del x, and guys, this is nothing but differentiating this term del u by del x with respect to y. So if I differentiate with this with respect to y, these both terms have y, so here I am going to use the product rule. So we will get y as it is, then the derivative of this term, so here x to the power y minus 1, in this y is the variable of differentiation and x is a constant, so that becomes equivalent to this a raised to x. So guys, we will get x to the power y minus 1 into log of x. So this is the derivative. So plus this x to the power y minus 1 term as it is, and derivative of y with respect to y is 1. Now guys, from these two terms I can take x to the power y minus 1 common, and in the bracket y log x will remain, plus 1 will remain. So here we will get it is equal to x to the power y minus 1 in bracket y log of x plus 1, and this is the value of del square u by del y del x. So guys, here we got the second order derivative. Now let's move to find out the final answer, that is the value of this del cube y by del x del y del x. And for this we are gonna differentiate partially with respect to x now. So here I'll say del cube y upon del x del y del x equal to, now guys, to get this value I'm gonna differentiate this function with respect to x again. Now let's start. So if I differentiate with respect to x, these both functions have x, so I'm gonna use the product rule. So x to the power y minus 1 will remain as it is, and let's find out derivative of this term. So here y as it is, derivative of log x is 1 upon x, and the derivative of 1 is 0 because I'm differentiating partially with respect to x, plus here 1 plus y log x as it is, and the derivative of this term with respect to x is y minus 1 into x to the power y minus 2. Now guys, here if I take this x in the numerator, that will become x to the power y minus 2. So x to the power y minus 2, x to the power y minus 2, I can take it common. Here we will get y, plus here we'll get 1 plus y log of x, and here y minus 1. Now guys, let's call this as equation number 2. Now let's observe equation 1 and 2. So you'll find that the value of equation number 1 and the value of equation number 2 is exactly same. So since the RHS of both the equation is same, we can equate the LHS, and therefore I'll say the given result is proved. So here I'll write down that result. So here we have proved the result which was given in the question. So I'm sure guys you understood how we have got the result. We have proved both the sides for the given function, and this was the problem which was the introductory problem on second order partial differentiation. So now you must have got the knowledge about how to find out the higher order partial differentiation or how to differentiate the given function successively. And now based on this, we are gonna cover more numericals, and keep watching the videos so that you will understand more numericals on this concept and you can get more knowledge about the partial differentiation. So guys, don't forget to share this channel with your friends and subscribe to this channel so that you can get more benefit of engineering mathematics and other channels of mathematics. So be there with Ekeeda. Thank you very much.